click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have did that how the methane molecule has been formed because of the hybridization, and now based on that only we are going to discuss about the another hybridization, that is during the formation of water molecule. So how and what are the hybridization that takes place so as to form a water molecule? Let us discuss about that. So now talking about the formation of a water molecule, it is very similar to that of what we have did in our previous lecture during the formation of methane molecule based on hybridization. And now that is what we are going to talk about, the water molecule. And water molecule is what we know it as H2O, or we could write it as HOH. So now talking about the central atom, because it is not necessary that we are only discussing about the hydrogen orbital, even that will undergo hybridization. That will not undergo hybridization. The reason behind that is it consists of that is only one unpaired electron, and that's the reason that in hybridization we have got to know that is the atoms which has atomic orbital, if they are mixing with each other so as to form new orbitals, only that will be able to form hybridization. So in this case, that's the reason we are choosing the central one. And in this case, in the previous one it was methane, and we have chosen the hybridization for carbon. And for water molecule we are choosing oxygen because it is the central one. And talking about the that is electronic configuration, so oxygen can be written as, electronic configuration can be written as 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. So this is what the oxygen has an electronic configuration, and we could make the orbital to be like this one, as you could see. The s orbital consists of only one orbital, or s subshell consists of only one orbital. While talking about the 2p subshell, it consists of basically three orbitals. So now let us fulfill the electrons over here, and we'll see in this manner that is the electron that are present in the 2s, that is basically 2. Talking about the 2p subshell, it consists of 4 electrons, so therefore 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is what we are following in Hund's rule, and this is what we are mentioning it over here. And now the thing that has been very much essential for us to understand, that is as you can see that there are two electrons or two unpaired electrons that are present. So according to valence bond theory also, it can make or it can form the two bonds with that of the hydrogen. But now talking about the oxygen, in this case basically this oxygen will be following the valence bond theory, but there are still more concepts that I am going to talk about, and that's the reason that separately I have made a lecture for the formation of water molecule. And in this case what will happen is, because oxygen we know that it consists of two lone pair of electrons, therefore I am mentioning it over here. So now this two lone pair of electrons will be basically the playing a vital role in basically giving the geometry to the water molecule. And how? Let me talk about that also. So in this case, if you observe that we have not excited it, because only thing that we did is we needed two electrons, and that is being fulfilled so as to form the two bond with that of hydrogen. But talking about this will undergo hybridization. Yes, the mixing will take place. And how? So now the second thing that we are going to do is we are going to discuss about the mixing and recasting so as to form the atomic orbitals. So talking about the water molecule, since it consists of basically 2s and 2p orbitals, so therefore they will combine with each other in such a way that if you observe that, in this case basically there will be four orbitals that will be formed after mixing. So these are the four orbitals, that is what I am mixing this to. So here I am going to indicate that I have mixed it. So after mixing, atomic orbitals. So this one, the one which has two electrons. So I'll keep it as it is. While the other one will also consist of two electrons, while this one will have one electron and one electron. So if you observe this thing, then this was s orbital, this was p orbital, this is again a p orbital, mainly p y, and this is p z. So basically everyone is basically contributing its atomic orbital so as to form a hybrid orbital, and that's the reason that this orbital, or this newly formed mixed atomic orbital, is known as atomic orbital that we could see. And the total number of atomic orbitals that we could see here, it would be 4, and this is basically known as sp3 hybridization. It will occur or we could say this all are basically sp3 hybrid orbitals. So let us draw the structure that how the what is the geometry of this sp3 hybridized atomic orbitals that we could observe for just for the oxygen when it is forming a water molecule. So that is what I am going to represent over here. So the structure of this is very much simple and very much similar to that of the tetrahedral geometry. The reason behind that is, let me tell you. So since it is forming sp3 hybridization, and this hybridization has a particular orientation, that is what we have discussed in our previous lecture, and it will have a particular geometry, and that is what since it is sp3 hybridization, obviously it will show that is a tetrahedral geometry. So this is what I'm explaining here. So this is one of the sp3 hybrid orbital. Even this is the sp3 hybrid orbital. There will be four sp3 hybrid orbital that we are going to discuss, because in the previous lecture also we have discussed that it will be the total number of hybrid orbitals that are been formed will be equal to that of the mixing of how many atomic orbitals has been mixed. So in this case, four atomic orbitals have been mixed, and that's the reason four new that is atomic orbital or hybrid orbitals have been formed. So this is what I am mentioning over here. So that's it. So this is for oxygen atom, and in this case basically we could see that the two lone pair of electrons are there. Also here it is a lone pair of electrons, so I am mentioning it here as two electrons. Here also there is two electrons. But meanwhile, this one will have basically one electron over here and one electron over here. So now the thing that we have to do is we have to mix. This is basically everything that has been formed over here is basically, I could say it as sp3 hybrid orbital. Similar to even this is sp3 hybrid orbital, and everything is sp3 hybrid orbital. And now they will form the bond with that of the hydrogen. And let us see that what will be the geometry for that. So again, let me draw this one. I'm not mentioning it here, just as to make any clear view that what we are talking about. So suppose this is one of the sp3 hybrid orbital of water, of oxygen basically, and this is again one of it, and this is what I'm talking about. So these are not linear, let me tell you again that obviously they are arranged in basically three dimension. Meanwhile, these two are basically on your side, this is on my side, and this is on the upper one, or basically you could say on the plane. And yes, let me mention the electrons also. So these are the two electrons of the lone pair of electrons of the oxygen atom. But meanwhile, this one is the electron of the oxygen atom that is unpaired, even this is unpaired. So now what will happen, suppose if the hydrogen is been combined. So hydrogen has only one electron, and that has basically only one that is, we could say, atomic orbital, and that consists of one electron. So therefore that is of spherical shape. So this is what I'm drawing is of the hydrogen atom, but meanwhile this one was of basically, I would say, for oxygen atom. So this is the hydrogen that has been attached over here, and again hydrogen will be attached over here. But talking about the hydrogen, that is, even hydrogen will have its electron. So that is what it is I'm mentioning over here, and here it is what I'm mentioning. So two hydrogens are now being successfully combined with that of the oxygen atom, and this is what the water molecule is. But what about the geometry? The geometry will be the same. It is basically the tetrahedral geometry that we could observe. And talking about what will the bond length over here. So talking about the previous one, that is when we are discussing about the methane, and in that case basically the carbon was not having any kind of, that is, we could say, lone pair of electron. And that's the reason the geometry was basically 109, or the bond angle was basically 109 degree 28 minutes, and the geometry was similarly that it's what you could see over here. But here it has basically lone pair of electrons, and this lone pair of electrons will be very much responsible so as to basically to repel the bonded electrons, and that's the reason that the angle is not like that of 109 degree 28 minutes. It will be less than that. And this is the one that is responsible so as to repel this kind of bond that has been formed over here. And even this will be the one which will be forming a repulsion between this. And that's the reason that the bond angle of here, it is not 109, it is less than 109. And meanwhile, we could also say that this two unpaired or this two lone pair of electrons, even they will have repulsion. And so somewhere we could say that the repulsion in this case is very much more. And that is what we see, that the structure of oxygen can be written as in this way. This is the oxygen atom over here, suppose, and suppose this is what hydrogen atom is, and this is what suppose another hydrogen atom is what I'm making it over here, and these are the lone pair of electrons, and even these are the lone pair of electrons of oxygen, suppose, because they are present in, as you see over here, they are present in this one. So the geometry is very simple to understand. It is very much similar to that of what we have did. So suppose this is the geometry that I'm going to explain. So this is very similar to that of the tetrahedral geometry, just like that of the methane one. But meanwhile, the bond angle in this case will be basically 104°27". So that is the bond angle of water. And this is how the lone pair of electron plays a vital role in repelling and reducing the bond angle. And that was a special thing that I was talking about in sp3. So every sp3 molecule doesn't have 109°28' bond angle. It can be less also. So that is what I was talking about. So that's it, friend. That is what I want to talk about. And I hope you have understood this lecture very clearly, and you have got to know that is how the sp3 hybridization takes place for water molecule. And I hope you will share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe again as well. Thank you so much.